In this lecture, we're going to discuss a method of circuit analysis called node voltage method. This method is referred to as a systematic method of circuit analysis, and that's because there are steps to follow, rules to obey, and then in general you'll end up with simultaneous equations that you'll need to solve. And the first step of this method is if a ground node is not already defined for you, you pick a node as your ground. And in theory, you can pick any node as your reference point, as your ground. But we'll see that strategic selection of ground nodes, when you do have a choice, can lead to less work for you to do, namely less equations for you to solve. So in a future lecture, we'll see an example of what I'm talking about here. But once you have a ground node, then the next thing you do is you write Kcl equations at your unknown nodes. And then once you have your Kcl equations, you use Ohm's law to get current in terms of voltage. And then when you're solving your simultaneous equations, that's what you're solving for. You're solving for voltage at nodes. So let's look at an example. Okay, this example here, where we have a couple of current sources and you can see some resistors. These resistors here are in K ohms, 1K ohm, 2.2 K ohms, 4.7 K ohms, and then this is a 500 ohm resistor. And you can see that the ground node, which is this bottom node, has already been defined for us. So remembering from previous discussion that we define voltage at ground as 0 volts. So see, this bottom node is defined to be at 0 volts. Okay, now we're going to look at the other nodes in the circuit. We have a node here, and we have a node here. Okay, so we got to think about, do we know the voltage at these nodes at this time? Well, look what's connected to this node over to the left, just resistors and this current source. Resistors aren't going to tell us anything about the voltage at the node at this point, because we don't know the currents through these resistors, right? We would have to know the currents to determine the voltage across them, which would then, help us get the voltage at this node with respect to ground. But we don't know those currents. Now, we know the current for this current source is 1 milliamp, but remembering the voltage current definition of an ideal current source, the fact that there's 1 milliamp flowing up through this source doesn't tell me anything about the voltage across it, because ideally I would have this amount of current no matter what the voltage across the current source is. So when you have resistors and when you just have resistors and current sources connected at a node, it's going to be unknown. It's going to start off unknown. So this I'm just going to label unknown node A. Likewise, this node over here, for the same reason, is unknown, and we'll call that node B. So once I have my unknown nodes identified, now I set up a Kcl equation at those unknown nodes. So I know that there's 1 milliamp flowing into node A, but now I'm going to define a current through this resistor here, this 1K, that I'll define going down, and I'm going to label it I1. Okay, and based on that current direction, the higher end voltage would be at the top. And I'm going to define a current going like this, that I'll call I2, that's leaving node A and entering node B. And again, based on that current direction, this would be the higher end of the voltage across the 500 ohm. And I'm going to define a current like this, I3. And I'll define a current like this, I4. And you see, it's arbitrary how you define these currents. You can pick any direction you want. You'll get the same answer. Okay, so you just arbitrarily pick the directions for these currents that you're defining. So now, once I have my current directions defined and the problem is set up, I can write my Kcl equations. So I'm going to do Kcl at node A. So at A, I got 1 milliamp flowing in. So I'm going to write that 1 milliamp as amps. So 1 milliamp is 0.001 amps. And then flowing out, I have I1 plus I2. Okay, and then over at node B, okay, so KCL at node B, I have 2 milliamps flowing in. Also, I have I2 flowing in to node B. Okay, because remember, I2 is flowing out of node A, and it's flowing into node B. And then those currents flowing in are going to equal the currents flowing out, which is I3 plus I4. All right, so those are my KCL equations. Now, I'm going to take these KCL equations, and I'm going to write the current through the resistors in terms of voltage using Ohm's law. So remember, Ohm's law, current is voltage divided by resistance. So at A, say, so this is the equation at node A, I'm still going to have the 0.001. Okay, now I1, when I write the voltage across this 1K, I'm going to start with the voltage on the higher end side and subtract from that the voltage on the lower end side. So I1, in terms of voltage, is going to be VA, that's the voltage on the higher end side, minus the voltage on the lower end side, which is ground, which is 0, and then divided by 1K. Now, I realize, you know, you don't have to write the minus 0, but the reason I do this, especially at the start, is just to emphasize that the voltage across that 1K, it's a difference, right? You're just taking the voltage on one end and subtracting the voltage on the other end, namely the voltage on the higher end and subtracting the voltage on the lower end. Okay, so I2, okay, which is the current through the 500 ohm, that's going to be VA, which is the voltage on the higher end, minus VB, the voltage on the lower end, divided by 500. All right, so you see, once you've done your KCL, then you've used Ohm's law. This is a node voltage equation. See, node voltage equation, your unknowns are node voltages. Okay, now at B, we'll have that, you got the 0.002 amps, okay, then plus I2, which again is going to be VA, minus VB over 500, and then that's going to equal, see, I3 is the current through the 2.2K, that's going to be VB, okay, VB minus 0 over 2.2K, and then I4 is going to be VB minus 0 over 4.7K. All right, so when we're done with the KCL and then Ohm's law, and we have our node voltage expressions, well, you can see that we have two equations, two unknowns, where the unknowns are the node voltages, VA and VB. So we can solve these simultaneous equations and get our answers. Now, before I show you, you know, the solution for VA and VB, let me just emphasize again that when you define these currents, the direction of these currents, when you're setting up the problem to write your KCL, it's arbitrary. And it should make sense to you that you would get the same answer if you chose different current directions. Because, for example, if I were to define I2 going the other direction here, if I define I2 going right to left, well, look what's going to happen mathematically. Mathematically, looking at node A here, the I2 term in the KCL equation would just go over to the other side of the equal sign. But in addition to that, when I write that current I2 in terms of voltage, the numerator of the ratio for Ohm's law will now be VB minus VA instead of VA minus VB. So you see it's a double negative that when you define a current going the opposite direction, mathematically it comes out the same because one, the term goes over to the other side of the equal sign, and two, the voltages flip, so you end up with the same thing mathematically. So I suggest that in this problem, you do exactly that on your own, you know, just have everything the same that we have here, but just change the direction of I2 and just convince yourself that you come up with the same equation. So therefore, it is arbitrary how you define the current directions. Now I'm going to show you my solution for VA and VB. I have it all already done here, as you can see. I used Kramer's rule, which is based on matrix algebra using determinants. And on PolyLearn, I've posted this handout here. So if you've never used Kramer's rule, or maybe you've used it but it's been a while, you can refer to this handout to become familiar with it again, or become familiar with it for the first time if you've never seen it before. And you know, here's the rule here, and then on the second page of this handout it shows a couple of examples. It shows a solution of a 2 equation 2 unknown and also a 3 equation 3 unknown. Okay, now I don't require that you use Kramer's rule to solve simultaneous equations. You know, if you want to do the good old substitution method, that's fine, or if you know some other method that you're comfortable with, that's fine. But from here on out in the quarter, you will need to solve simultaneous equations. So using Kramer's rule on this problem, VA, the voltage at node A with respect to ground, comes out to 1 2/3 volts, and VB, the voltage at node B with respect to ground, comes out to 2 volts. So in the next video, we'll take these answers for VA and VB, and then we'll use them to find any circuit quantity that we desire in the circuit for any of the elements. So we'll do that next.